गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ अक्षय कुमार श्रीवास्तव एंड दिस इज़ माय न्यू वीडियो ऑफ क्लास फिफ्थ एंड योर चैप्टर इज चैप्टर 3 स्टार्ट मेन्यू एंड कंट्रोल पैनल एंड टूडेज टॉपिक इज चेंजिंग माउस प्रॉपर्टीज. इन दिस वी हैव टू सी दैट सेटिंग द डबल क्लिक स्पीड ऑफ द माउस, सेटिंग द पॉइंटर स्कीम फॉर द माउस, चेंजिंग डेट एंड टाइम सेटिंग्स एंड last is that removing programs. That is given on your page number, I think 28, 29 and page number 30. So we start changing mouse properties. The mouse is a primary input device for working in Windows. Using the control panel, we can change the setting of the mouse according to our requirement. Okay students, I think as you know, mouse is a very important input device, and if you want to change the properties of mouse, then you can easily change the properties of mouse using the control panel according to your requirements. Okay, so if setting the double click speed of the mouse, if we want to change the double click speed of the mouse, then follow these steps to set the double click speed of the mouse. First, open the control panel and click on the hardware and sound category. Second, click on the mouse link under devices and printers to open the mouse properties dialog box. Third, click on the buttons tab. Fourth, click here if you are a left-handed and want to see the left mouse button as the right button and the right mouse button as the left mouse button. Drag the speed slider in a suitable direction to set the double click speed or as slow or fast. 6. Double click here to check the double click speed. 7. Click on apply button to apply the settings. 8. And click on OK to close the dialog box. So this, in this way you have to change the double click speed of the mouse. So I will show you. First you open a mouse pointer hardwares. How you can? First you open a control panel. Click on start menu and there is a control panel on the right pane. Click here and then you have to click on hardware and sound. Hardware and sound. This is the hardware and sound category. Click here and hardware and sound. Click on mouse link under this. Mouse link is where? Here is a mouse. Okay. Click there. Mouse link. Now this will mouse properties window will open, and if you want to click the double change the double click speed as so as fast, so here is a slider. If you move this slider here and there, then the double click speed is according to the slider, it will be adjusted. If you want to make more faster, then you have to move here, and if you want to slow, then you have to move into the left hand side. Okay, double click the folder to test your setting. If the folder does not open or close, trying using a slower setting. Okay, and this is the switch button configuration. This is the way from which you can change the left mouse button as a right and right mouse button as a left mouse button. Okay, if you click here, then now the left button is working as a right button and right button is working as a left button. Okay, if you want to open this, okay, and again you want to change, then click and open a mouse. Okay, and by changes you have to click on apply. If you changes anything, then click on apply button and then the settings will be applied and changing will be applied. Through this you can change the left mouse button as a right mouse button and right mouse button as a left mouse button, and through this you can change the speed of the double click speed. If you want to make faster, then move to the right hand side. If you want to make slower, to move the left hand side. Okay, and one thing is that pointers scheme, setting the pointer scheme for the mouse. Follow these steps to set the pointer scheme for the mouse. Open the mouse properties dialog box, click on the pointers tab, click to see a list of the pointer schemes, select a scheme by clicking on it. Fourth, the pointers of the selected scheme will be displayed here. Click on the apply button to apply the pointer scheme. Click on OK button to close the dialog box. Okay, so if you see that pointer, which type of setting is that? That is this type of pointer scheme is here. Okay, it's normal selection. So if you want to change the pointer scheme, then you have to click on the properties dialog box and click on the properties dialog box. Okay, here pointers, and that is a normal. If you want to change any theme, scheme is there. There are too much schemes are there, extra large system. This, if you want to this type of, then you have to select and click on apply now. And now look, that pointer scheme is changes. Now the pointer scheme is changes. Okay, there are various, if you, this way you can change the pointer scheme. Okay, you have to click on pointers, and here from you select the scheme, which scheme you want, then you have to click. Normal is that window arrow scheme, and if you want to change any schemes like this, like that, any schemes, okay, then you have to click on apply button, and that it will be applied. Okay, this is the way. Okay students, now changing date and time settings. We can change the date and time displayed in the notification area of the taskbar by following these steps. Open the control panel and click on the clock, language and region category. Click on the date and time link to open the date and time dialog box. Third, in the date and time dialog box, click on the change date and time to open the date and time settings dialog box. Fourth, select the month and year as required. Fifth, select the required date from the month calendar. Sixth, enter the required time. Seventh, click on OK button to close the dialog box. 8th, click on the OK button in the date and time dialog box to close it. How you can change the date and time? So I will show you. First you open a control panel. Okay, and from here you have to click on that clock, language and region. Click here, and this is the date and time. Click on that date and time. Okay, this window will appear, that is given on your book also. This window will appear. Here is a change date and time. So you have to click here, change date and time. Okay, now this window will appear. Here is also given on your book. This type of window will appear again. So this is the, this window will appear through this. This is the calendar. If you want to change the date, then you have to move this like that. That arrow keys are moving back and moving forward. You have to change the date, and you want to change the time, then you have to click here on this and write any time which you want and click on OK. Okay, the date and time will changes. Okay, according to this you can change the date and time. Okay students, another way is also that, do you know, you can also open the date and time dialog box by clicking on the date and time displayed in the notification area on the taskbar, then select the change date and time settings link from the windows that pops up. From here you can also change the date and time. This is the notification area where the date and time settings are available. You have to click on that, and this window will appear. Here is written what, change date and time settings. This will be clicked, and that window will appear. From here you have to click change date and time, and according to the, this is the calendar, you can change the date as you required and change the time as you required and click on OK. Okay students, I think all of you understand. All of you have a system at your home, then you have to practice it. Okay students, and one thing is that, removing programs. We can remove those programs which we no longer need from our computer easily. The steps to do it are as follows. Open the control panel and click on OK. Click on the uninstall a program link from under the programs category. Second, the programs and features screen is displayed listing all the programs that you have installed on your computer. Third, select the program that you want to remove. Fourth, click on the uninstall button. Program with all its components will get removed from the computer. Okay students, if you have any program that you not a longer use, then you have to uninstall that program. Like in your smartphone, you also uninstall some apps which you want to not use. Okay, then you have to uninstall that app. So like that, you have to also uninstall a programs from your computer. You have to click here, programs, and here is a given uninstall a program. You have to click on that. Okay, and that list is given here. All that programs that is stored on your system. If you have to uninstall any program, then if I want to uninstall, I will show you. You have to click here. If I want to uninstall this, then click here, and here is that uninstall and changes. You have to click uninstall. Then next, follow the steps, uninstall, and that program, now program is uninstalled from my computer. Okay, this is the way through which you can uninstall a program. You have to click on that listed program, which program you want, then select that listed program, and from that you have to click on the uninstall, and that the program will get removed from the computer. Okay students, I think all of you understand. If you have any problem, then you can message me, and that will come there like that. You have to click on that finish. That Photon Plus software is uninstalled from my computer. So if you have any problem, then you have to message me, and you have to practice all that things that is given on page number 28, 29 and 30. And if you have any problem, then tell me. Thank you. Have a nice day.